intro to node is a remix of intro to JS, but there's a lot more files because you have to add a couple of more configurations in order for Glitch to know that you're working with a server-side application. So if you look at the README, I have a very short introduction to node where I talk about servers and how they give you the information that you need when you go to a URL. And I've also explained in the bottom what files there are to make the application full stack. The most important one is package.json. JSON is JavaScript object notation. It allows you to configure your node application by telling the server how to run it. To run a node app, you just run the command node and then the server file that has all of your server-side code, which we'll take a look at in a sec, and what dependencies you have. We happen to be using Express, which is a way to write node in a concise and easy way for us as human developers to get the server running.
Node.js is a very modern and popular web server to run web applications. And it's particularly appealing because the programming language you use to run your Node.js web server is JavaScript. So since you're getting into development and you're already having to learn JavaScript for the front-end work, it's very convenient not to have to learn an additional language for the back-end. A web server is just a computer somewhere that has the job of sending that HTML and the CSS and the JavaScript down to the client in the web browser. And every website, it's being hosted by a web server somewhere, but often they're very, very simple, and they're just sending your HTML and your JavaScript. It's sending the same thing to every single person. So when you have your very own Node.js web server, if you choose to, you can take control of the content that's sent down every single time someone asks for it. And so this allows you to do more advanced things in your application, like allow the user to log into your site so you know who they are. And then when you respond to them, maybe you send different content to different people. And so the place that all of the logic and the ideas and the processing live for differentiating your users, or even just doing things like incrementing a site visitor counter or changing a picture of the day, all that set of logic would live in the Node web server rather than in the user's perspective on the client in your common HTML and JavaScript.
Now that you have your app configured in package.json, we have to create server.js because that's what the node command is looking for. And in it, we create our Express app. We set a public folder where we'll have our static files. So you'll notice that I've renamed app.js and style.css to be in the folder called public. So I tell Express, public is our public static folder. And then I create endpoints for routes. So when the user goes to intro.node.glitch.me, we need the server to return our index.html view. We call them view because that's what the client can see. And so when they go to the index, we want to send index.html. And if they go to our app/about.html, we are going to send them the about.html file. And notice that we renamed index.html and about.html to be in the /views folder. And we've added another JSON file, resolutions.json. It's not configuration for the server, it's just information that I think is useful to the app. I want to start tracking every day if I am keeping up with my resolution. And here I have two items for day one and day two, and I talk about what I've done to see if I've read up, which is what my resolution is. And then I've updated app.js to look at that information. And if the number of items in my resolutions.json equals the number of days that we are in, I'm going to assume that I am keeping my resolution. And if they aren't equal, then that means no, I'm not keeping up to date. And since we're a little over a week into the year, and I only have two resolutions in my JSON, my app should say that no, I am not keeping my New Year's resolution. So this is just one of many ways to use server-side code to handle data and manipulate it, and update your page automatically so that you don't have to go into index.html every single day and update your status or what the day is.
And there you have it. In this series, we have taken our website and gone full stack and learned three languages along the way, HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, and wrote JavaScript using the Node framework to take it server side, which is a lot. And if you need more resources, I suggest you check out the MDN web docs. You can go to developer.mozilla.org, and there's a whole wealth of information tutorials on all of those languages and technologies. Also go to glitch.com. We have a learn to code section with tutorials on Node and also all those other languages. And if you get stuck in a glitch app, highlight the code and you can ask the community for help.